The Chesapeake Bay has faced many challenges over the years in terms of water quality and biodiversity reduction, and we're really starting to see improvements, and a lot of that is due to the good work that farmers are doing within Pennsylvania and within some of the other states.
One of the main reasons we got into the 4R and the conservation end of things is the river behind me. There's no bigger thrill than reeling in a 40-inch rockfish out of the Chesapeake Bay. I want that to continue. I want my kids to be able to go out there and experience that. We will do anything here at this farm to make sure we are protecting that water source.
For our nutrient stewardship, it comes down to applying the right nutrient source for the crop at the right rate to maximize that crop uptake, and at the right time and at the right place to maximize nutrient use efficiency, all with the goal of enhancing the profitability for the farmer, so helping them economically, but also keeping those nutrients in the field where crops use them and out of our waterways, so it's an environmental benefit as well.
We provide a space to have nutrient stewardship and nutrient management conversations where all parties can come to the table, express their concerns, and learn what's important to the other stakeholders and leave with a plan to implement nutrient stewardship on a farm-wide and statewide basis.
Back in 2012 was the inception of the Pennsylvania 4R Alliance. And the PA4R Alliance is a group of organizations, just like it is in the national and international scale of ag stakeholders.
It's an industry-led initiative. They want to help farmers, they want to provide technologies, and they also don't want to lead to water quality issues.
The State Conservation Commission, as well as all the other regulatory agencies, see the value in 4Rs for primarily education, and outreach to the farming community. Outreach and education coming from the agricultural community, coming from the ancillary services and agribusiness really help. As well as the field days that are offered by the 4R Alliance, it gets us out, it gets our conservation districts out to see what's actually occurring on the land.
One of the things that I truly believe is a benefit to agriculture in general is you've got folks like the Nature Conservancy and TFI, the Fertilizer Institute, and some of the extension folks coming under this 4R umbrella to work together. We all have the same common goal. We all want clean water. We all want good soil. We all want to leave things better.
The Nature Conservancy is a science-driven organization. We value the data in making our decisions on what conservation practices we want to promote, and 4R nutrient stewardship fits in with that because it is such a science-driven approach.
Even if we're applying 4R practices, we still need to make sure that we have edge of field and off-site best management practices in place so that if we do have nitrogen moving from our field out of the field boundary, we have waterways, we have riparian buffers, and other edge of field practices that can help soak up that nitrogen before it enters the surface water and becomes a problem.
So down below here in this valley, there's an old like logging road, and it goes down to two cabins on a river. And we go down there and walk a lot of times. Well, just to show how much water can move stuff, if you go down there, there's like a little beach. There's peach pits down there. So like they're washing down this hill, washing into the streams, and getting down there to the river. So like the fertilizer stuff we can't see, but then a peach pit you can see when it. That's a lot of ground to travel all the way down to that river.
With the scale of the problem in terms of water quality in the Chesapeake Bay, we recognize that we all need to work together and be a part of that conversation in order to help farmers achieve the water quality goals we've set forth.